Well, Queensland Treasurer Cameron Dick handed down his second budget this afternoon, claiming the state is returning to surplus, despite recording a $3.8 billion deficit this year. According to Dick, the Sunshine State's going to become the Sunrise State, he says, as it recovers from the COVID pandemic. But the bigger picture isn't so rosy. Total debt set to reach $127 billion by 2024, and the public sector wage bill set to soar more than $30 billion in the same year. For his analysis, I'm joined from Brisbane by former Queensland Premier Campbell Newman. All right, Campbell Newman, you know your way around a Queensland budget. There's a lot of debt there for a state to carry. There's also great increases, significant increases in the public service. What's your overall view of what you heard today?
Well, it's very clever from a political point of view, Peter, but I'd characterise this budget with four sort of headline things which we've got the time, if we've got the time, we'll get into. One is deficit, one is debt, one is a really shonky bit of accounting to do with the titles office and some supposed gains from that. And then there's where they're pulling the wool over the eyes with people in relation to infrastructure spending. So perhaps to start at the beginning with the deficit, and I'll use the benchmark year 2014, the budget of my treasurer, Tim Nicholls. Back in those days, so if I look at the population of Queensland, compare it today, the population's gone up by 10% since then in 7 years, Peter, roughly 10%. Well, the revenue that this government pulls in, now remember that's taxes, that's rego, that's the impost they put on Queenslanders, has gone up by 27%. But to show the fact that these people can't even control their budget, their spending's gone up by 34%. So 10% increase in population, they got 27% more revenue that they sucked out of the hide of Queenslanders, but they've spent 34% more. They're actually in their own figures showing employee expenses going up by 4.5% in only 1 year. And this is the poor and reckless financial management. And then they have the gall to publish in the main budget summary on page 70 this chart. I don't know if it's coming up well on camera, but it's a bit like the heroic projections of Wayne Swan years ago, those infamous projections about getting back into surplus. You know, there's a yawning chasm here where I've circled, which is this year, over $3.5 billion, but then miraculously they're going to close the gap after the last 7 years with that poor track record. What happens to debt? Well, you've already mentioned that. That's gone from about $80 billion that we had it stabilised at in 2014 to $127 billion, as you've said, a 37% increase. So that's my opening sort of salvo there, Peter. Ask me about this shonky, shonky bit of accounting that they're pulling with the sale or transfer of the titles office.
Well, I want to ask you about public servants, but tell us about the titles office.
Well, a bit of context. The New South Wales government in 2017 privatised with a 35-year lease their titles office and reaped $2.6 billion. The Victorian government followed suit with a sale in 2018 at $2.86 billion. So this mob here are telling Queenslanders with a straight face that it's worth, the Queensland titles office is worth $7.8 billion. They're going to spend $1.8 billion of that gain and transfer those $6 billion into a thing called the Debt Retirement Fund. So for the people in business out there, what they're doing is this, it's like they're saying, we're going to create on our balance sheet a reserve fund and say, you know, that building over there, well, it's now worth a massive amount extra. So lo and behold, suddenly our balance sheet's improved. It's a director's valuation, if you like. Well, I'm
people
sure they've
aren't
put
stupid,
some numbers
surely
on the table. Yeah.
And, I've got a lot of faith in Queenslanders. They're going to just go after this.
Well, look, the Auditor General, that's who I think of immediately, Peter, should be looking serious at this one. And I don't know if really this meets the standard of governance that one would expect of a state government in this day and age. I mean, you just can't say that this thing is worth that much money. And I mean, they're not selling it. They're putting it into this fund, but magically, through this transfer process, it's worth a lot more. What does that mean? Cameron Dick stands up and the Premier stands up and they say, hey, the net debt position, it's better than we thought. Look, the debt isn't as high as we were saying it might get to. Still at $127
billion. Campbell,
you know, these are
Just quickly before I go, Campbell, because I'm going to have to get over to Downing Street when we go live there, but talk to me about public service. In 2007, Peter Beattie leaves office, 185,000 public servants in Queensland. There are now 235,000. Now, if you and I were speaking to Queenslanders, no one would say that the improvements have been any higher or better with, what, 50,000-odd new public servants.
Look, it's a full employment program for our card-carrying union members, I have to cynically say, and I don't mean to reflect poorly on public servants who are at the front line and do a good job, but there are far too many people not doing enough. We've got ambulance ramping back. We'd eliminated it. We had the best surgery waiting times in the nation back in 2014. You hear a lot about cuts. What we introduced, though, Peter, was better management. Now we have more bodies, but clearly not being well, the place being well run, and there are all sorts of problems. And the probably right. Another point I should make before you have to wind up is the issue of infrastructure, because, you know, I'm going to give them something here. They are actually spending more than we did, because we had to step on the brakes in a per capita terms on infrastructure. But my objection is they told Queenslanders that they're going to spend all this money. They told Queenslanders that they didn't have to privatise or have long-term leases on government-owned assets, and yet they're not spending enough money to deal with the growing demands of Queensland, and indeed they've cut $4 billion out of the Ford estimates for infrastructure spending. So they got the big announcement in the last couple of years, we're going to spend all this money on infrastructure, but then as you roll forward, they're not actually going to spend the money. And they're rebranding, for example, about $1.3, $1.4 billion in the hospital's health area. It's old wine in new bottles. So there's a lot of shockiness going on in this, of smiles from the Premier and the Treasurer.
Now that they've got the federal government to get on the sticky paper about 50-50 funding for this Olympic build, should they get the bid up, of course, that means a whole lot of stuff's going to be thrown in there. Got to go. Campbell Newman, thank you for that analysis.
Thanks, Peter.